I don't have to look deep and down and say, this really the fight I wanted. And I think he's done that. I mean, he probably won't say that to the guy. He's probably going to keep going on with it. He's going to knock me out. He's going to do this. But I think deep down, he knows that this is going to be a tough fight.
Chad, are you mentally prepared for this fight? Like, if he tries to play mind tricks with you and everything? Tries to do 10 push-ups in the round?
Hey, if he does those push-ups, man, hey, I'm just going to get on his ass, man. I mean, I'm not going to play around. But, I mean, like I said, at the end of the day, Bernard, he has to come in the ring. He has to execute. You know, he said he was going to knock me out. He got to prove to everybody that he can knock me out.
Bernard didn't pick us for the fight. We trapped him. We've been chasing him for a good 3 years.
Yeah.
I mean, solid 3 years. So Saturday night, Chad is going to get his wish, and Bernard is not going to get his wish.
No, I gotta prove to everybody that he's the older man, I'm the younger guy, and I got what it takes to be the champion, next champion. And I want to be the next great champion. I want to be in the position that Bernard's in, the position he's in. I don't want to fight till I'm 46 years old, though. You know, maybe 35, 36, but, I mean.
What's your dream fight, or what's your dream
fight? This is my dream fight right here.
He's fought some tough guys. Yeah. Taylor, Pavlik,
yeah.
Cal Zachary. Where do you see yourself in that category?
I can run with the best of them. And those guys were the best of them. And I'm up there with them. I'm in the same category, if not better.
No, you're better. Oh, hold on. Who'd you just name? Taylor, 160 pounds. Pavlik, 160 pounds. What happens when he fought Calzaghe? Loss. I rest my case.
Do you break down tape, and if you did for this fight, which did you look at the best of him and also the losses? Did you mix it up?
Being so much younger than Bernard, I had the opportunity to watch him for years.
So, fair enough.
I mean, I pretty much got the sense of what I'm in for.
Sure.
Scully, I know Scully broke down everything. He had the opportunity to watch Bernard for years. So, I mean, I think everybody in the gym had the opportunity to watch Bernard for years. Yeah, it's been years. Yeah. So, I mean, I pretty much know. I leave it up to Scully. Whatever Scully tells me to do, I'm going to do it. That night of the fight, if Scully tells me, Chad, you got to do this, you got to do that, that's what I'm going to do. If he tells me, Chad, you got to throw this elbow right to his chest, I'm going to throw elbow to his chest because I know the game plan that he's laid out is great. I mean, I've never seen a trainer like Scully. Like, he's so hyper, so happy about it. I don't know if you know, but he's just crazy about everything. He wrote me some notes and everything, man, and I was like, wow. I mean, I sat up all night and I read over, and I think I read over the notes like 5 times, just trying to, you know, put it in my head, the notes that he went and typed up notes and everything. So, I mean, he's serious about his job, and I got to show him how serious I am about my job, too.
Chad.
On the night of the fight, I think it's going to be a great combination, a deadly combination. So, me and John Scully.
If Bernard Hopkins was right next to you, what would you tell him?
Right next to me?
Yeah.
Take a hike. This is my time to shine. It's definitely my time to shine.